Alright, welcome back to Web School. So we are in episode 4 of our web journey. So, and in this video, we are going to be talking about attributive depths. Alright, so guys, if you have not subscribed to the channel, make sure you subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss anything as the course is unfolding. So make sure you watch the previous video before watching this one, because in the previous video we talked about elements and we introduced attributes. But in this element now, we are in this episode, we are going to dive into attributes. So let me go and open my Sublime Text. Alright, so I've increased the font size so that you can see what is happening on the screen here. So we are talking about attributes. So what are attributes? The HTML attributes provide additional information about the HTML element, just as we saw earlier. So we are going to talk about so many different attributes that you can see in HTML. So all HTML elements, all of them, they can have attributes. An attribute provides additional information about the element. The attributes are always specified in the start tag. So the attributes, they are always in the start tag. You put them in the start tag. Then you don't put anything in the end tag. So you put all the attributes in the start tag. The attributes are always specified in the tag start tag. And the attributes usually come in name value pairs. I'll talk about name value pairs. We mean something like this. So you give them something like name of the attributes equals to, now put the value of the attribute inside the double quotes. I hope it's understood. So don't worry, we are going to dive into example very soon. So the first attribute we are going to see is the href attribute. The href, we saw it in the previous video, the href attribute that is put in the anchor element. Now you should always make sure that if you have not saved anything, like you see, if I'm typing here, this file is not saved. The first thing when you open Sublime Text that you need to do is you save it. And if you are saving for the first time, it's going to ask you to give a name. So let's give attributes. See, if you are talking about attributes is the name of our HTML file. .html. Remember, here you must select all files. Either select all files, or you come here and select HTML. Any one of them will do. So make sure that your file that is in this part is given an extension .html. If not, Sublime Text is not going to help you with autocomplete suggestions. So remember, we have to put in our basic scaffolding HTML. Click. It's going to give us a basic HTML page. So we are talking about the href attributes. Href attributes can be used. Href attributes can be used in the anchor tag, the anchor element. So we have A here. But click is going to complete it. So you see here, this is the start tag of the anchor element. So we say the attributes, they are always placed in the start tag of the element here, like this. So this one href is an attribute, we call it an attribute. So any name value pairs that we put before or that we put inside the beginning tag of an element, we call it an attribute. So What essentially this HWeb attribute does, the HWeb attribute specifies the URL of the page that the link goes to. As we said earlier, now if you say this is a link, this is a link. Now this is our link. Now this is where we specify where the link we're going to. For example, we say one that every the user click on this link, it should take us to www.google.com. Now if I save this, I have to go down to my folder I've saved. Remember, our folder is test. Here we are working with the attributes. So now you see this is a link here. So this is the attribute, this is HWeb attribute. You use it when you want to specify a link that when a user clicks on, the link should take him to. So the next attribute we are going to see is the source attribute. The source attribute is used inside an image, is used inside an image tag. An image tag, IMG. An image tag is missing like this, IMG. And you should know that, and if the image tag is does not have a closing tag, so this source attribute specify the URL of the image that you want to insert into the web page. For example, now if I want to insert an image, let me go and look for an image. Let me see if I can get some images. Where can I get some images? No. Okay, let me look for some images. Now, let's say I want to display this image in a web. Let's say I want to display this image in a web browser. Now, what I'll do is I just come to my folder, my desktop. I'm going to paste my image here. Paste it. So let me just rename it. Now remember, this source attribute specifies the path where this image is going to look for the this image tag is going to look for the image. So I want the image to display the image that we have just saved in our folder recently. Remember, we are in the current folder, so since this HTML file is in the same folder with this image, so I just need to put the image here. Okay, so now since I've saved, if I go to the web browser, you see the image is here. It's showing that there's an image here. It's not going to show the image because we need the extension of the image. We need the extension of the image. So let's look at the extension of the image. Folder option. Come here, you see hide extensions from known file types. So this option hides the extension for all the files that you have. So when you click here, you see apply, you're going to see the extension of the image. You see, before we're not seeing the extensions of all these files here. So we need to come here and put the exact file that we are looking for. So the extension of the file is .png. So first.png. Okay, save. Now you see it's going to display. You will see the image in your browser. So that's how you include an image in the web page. So the next attribute you are going to see is before we talk about the next attribute, I still want to elaborate on this source attribute. Remember I told you that we are putting here first.png because this our file here is in the same directory as one. Now if I create a new folder, now I say I want to create a new folder to be storing my images. Let me say I'm putting images here, images, because I want to separate my image from my HTML document. I copy my image and put it here. Now if I go to the web page and refresh, you see the image is not showing because it has looked in the current directory and it's not seeing this first.png. So we need to tell the image tag that they should look for it in the image folder. When you enter the image folder, before you now you look for the file called first.png. So essentially this is what this one means here. So this one means that enter the image folder, then you look for the file called first.png. And the way of naming this, or the way of passing this URL, is called a relative URL, because it is a URL that is relative to this current HTML element. So we are giving a URL related to this one. There's another one you can pass called absolute URL. But before we go there, let's save the change and see how it's going to go. Fresh. Remember, is images folder, save. Come here and refresh. Now you see it is seeing back our image. Now let me show you another way of passing this URL. Now if you come to this image, if I expand it, you see when you look at the top here, you discover that you are seeing a URL here. This one is the absolute URL of the image. It tells it is the position where the image is actually found in the computer, so it's not relative to this current folder here. So I can say come there, copy that image, go back here, come here, copy this part, come here, and I change it to this one. You see, now you see, this is, you enter the C drive, enter the users, this is my username, the computer username, then the file is on the desktop. After you get to the desktop, you enter the test folder. After you enter the test folder, you enter the images folder. Now this is the image where the image is, this is the part of the image located, but you actually also need to give the name of the image, and in this case we call it the first.png. So if I save now and I go back to my browser, you see it's still showing. So these are the two ways you can do to pass image URL to a source, but this one is actually not a good idea of always passing absolute URL. So we always do a relative URL. A relative URL is a URL of the image with respect to the file in which it is contained. So the folder related to this file, to the folder where this our document is. So from the current folder, you need to enter the images folder, then we look at the file first.png. So you should save. Yeah, refresh. You see it here again. So the next attribute you are going to see is the width and the height attributes. The width and the height attributes specify the size of an HTML element. Now, for example, now you see this image. You see this image is displayed. This is the default size of the image. Now, if I want to display a very big image, I can come here and I put the height attribute. If I want to change the height of the image, I can say, let it be, you specify it in pixel. So here we have, if I want to give the height to be 200, I come here. If I put here 200, I come save. If I refresh, you see there is 200. If I want it to be very large, I can put 2000 here. So when you refresh, you see the image now is very, very large. So that's how you control the height of your image. Now you can also control the width of your image. If I come here, I say width. If I want the width to be 40, very small. If I save, I come here, I refresh, you see. Though the height is 2000, but you see the width is only 40. So that's how, those are the attributes you can use on this image element. So we have the height, we have the width, we have the source attributes, and we have also seen the href attribute. So we are going to go to the next attributes, and the next attribute we are going to be seeing, we just reduce it here since it's not too good to see. Come here and refresh. No, it's too small. Now let me see 100 here. And let me also see here 100. Okay, let's just leave that way. So now another attribute we are going to see is the alt attribute, and this alt attribute is also used in the image tab. This alt attribute is used to display an alternative text in case this image is not found. So this is going to be displayed if the source attribute does not find the image. Okay, now if I save this, now let me make it in such a way that we not find the image. Let me just remove this. You see, it's not going to see this image because there's no image saved as first.png. So if I go to the web browser and refresh, you see, since it does not find the image, it's going to display the text. So the alt is the alternative to the image. So it's going to be displayed when the image is not found. If I come back here, I save, and I go refresh, you see. If the image is found, it's going to display the image. If the image is not found, it's going to display the text. Then the next attribute we are going to be seeing is the style attribute. The style attribute is used to style an element. So for example, now let's come here. If I want to style this element, I want to add some style, you see. Let me come here. Remember we talked about the break attribute, so as to give us a little break before on between these two elements here. Okay, let's add another break so that they can be more visible. Copy, and then let's add a horizontal line here to differentiate between the two of them. Alright, now you see this is our link that we displayed earlier on. Now if I want to style this link, I see that this link is not quite good. If I want to style it, I can now come here I put all the styles in this style attributes. Now for example, if I say I want the font width to be bold, or let's say bolder, don't worry, this is CSS. We are going to dive deep into CSS after we are done with HTML. So but if you can't wait to get started with CSS, if you have already done the base of HTML, you can comment down below and I'm going to do the CSS course right away. So do not bother about all of these things you are seeing now. You are going to learn them, you are going to do them, take it from scratch and teach you all what these ones mean. So this font width, it means it should make this text to be bold. So if I save, let's go and view what we have done in the browser. You see this text now become bold. If I want to give a background color, say background, give a background color to this, I want the background color of black. So if I save, I come here, refresh, you see that this link now has a background color of black. So that is the style attribute is used to style the HTML element. So that is the attribute you understand that this attribute is what helps to color an HTML element. Now I want to talk about another attribute called the lang attribute. Now you see this HTML, when Google usually searches for web pages, it looks at this lang attribute of an HTML element. Now this lang attribute tells Google the language of this HTML document. So the language here, since we are using English, the language of this HTML document is EN. Now if you want the language of this HTML document to be French, it's going to be displayed to people who are looking for French results. You see, you change this, the language attribute, you define the language of the HTML page here. Where is it? But since it's English, let's put here EN. So that's the language attribute is actually ENUS. It says the English of the United States. So that is it. So the next attribute we are going to be talking about is the title attribute. Now I can give a title to this HTML anchor element. I say title here, and what the title attribute does, the title attribute gives the title of the HTML element. For example, I'm going to show you in a moment what this one means. So this is a title. You say this is the title. Okay, now this is the title of this anchor element. So the way it works is, if I come and I refresh here, now look at when I hover over this, you see it's going to say this is the title. Whatever you write here, whatever you write in this title element, is going to be displayed when the mouse is hovered on the element. You see, look at this, the title. Now it's not going to be displayed here because I have not given a title attribute here. Now what if I come here and also give a title attribute? You can put it in any order. Attributes can be put in any order in the tag. The title, so I want to give a title of image. Let me say image. Remember, you always need to open and close your bracket. My image, if I save, I come here. Now when I hover on the image, you see my image. So that is what the title attribute does. So I want to wrap up this video by giving you some basic good practices when it comes to attributes. Actually, attributes is a good practice to always write attributes in small letters. So HTML, even though HTML standard does not require you to write, it does not force you to write it in capital letter. For example, if I put here, or let me say star, if I come here and say star in capital letters, it's still going to function the same way. See, all of the things are still displayed because it interprets the style attribute. So, but it's always good practice to put it in, to put all the attributes in small letters. So you always put it in small letters. Okay. And then coming to the quotes, you can also use single quotes here to wrap the attribute values. Can use single quote here. It's not a must to use double quotes, but it's always a good practice to use double quotes whenever you're putting the value of an attribute. It's always a good practice to use double quotes. So that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do so. Click the red subscribe button and also click on the red on the notification bell so that when the next video is released, you are not going to miss it. So also consider liking my video and also sharing it. So until the next video, bye bye.